All right, max this bad boy. Get expensive. There we go. And, ooh. That's actually expensive to upgrade. That's, Oh, is it? It's pristine. That's why. Okay. And repair. Thank you. Oh, we're ready to rock and roll, chat. We're ready to rock and roll. Come get some. Ooh, I want to try it. I want to try it on you. Come here. Come here. Get down here. How do you not hear your body dying? Oh, hi. Oh, I should have had him hit me. Hit me. Hit me. Come here. No. Oh, I said hit me. Oh, well. We'll try it here soon, chat. Perfect. Are you melee? No, you don't look like melee. No, you're not melee. Wait, what was that? Oh, hi. See, where's the, is this? Yep, it's a shotgun. Digging the name, though. I need to find one of you. No, 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 no. Sir, sir. There you go. All right, so melee after a while. It might be pretty broken, chat. All right, who's... Give me a little... Mm-hmm. Little on the broken side. All right, so we're looking for Amber Heights. Should be across right over here. God, those like weird ass mushroom trees sort of remind me of Morrowind. I don't think they worked on Morrowind, did they? I know they worked on Fallout 1 and 2 in New Vegas, but I don't think they worked on a Elder Scrolls IP. Better than nature. She looks it too. Damn. All right, I've done everything you want.
If you just listen.
No, no more listening, no more preaching. We are losing people left and right. We need to act.
Enough, Zora. I'm not putting the torch to innocent people. Do you want to bring the board's cruisers and gunships down on us? Captain, apologies, but our situation grows dire. Our people talk of foolish endeavors. What news do you bring?
Their gunships. They sure didn't stop me from landing here. Brandon Press is all yours.
Excellent.
Did you find the Vianois?
Yep. And they're on the way back.
Thank the Eternal.
We're one step closer to bringing the truth to every man, woman, and child in Halcyon. For now, you can tell Hiram that I'll stop using Devil's Peak.
Cool.
From the pits of our eternal souls. Thank you, Captain. I have much to do. Articles to write, sermons to ponder. We live in such an exciting time. Let's talk later.
Hey, I need to see to the wounded, but drop by the clinic when you can. I want a word.
Ooh, revolt in a revolt. Is that a secondary? Might be secondary. Is that secondary? Secondary. With airways cleared, inform Haram that the WP's broadcast tower is now. It's time for him to get to work. And where is that? Ooh, that's over there. Mm-hmm. Let's see, I am... Where am I at? River Heights. We'll move the ship one more time.
I believe I hear Felix and Parvati.
I think goes over there, that goes over there, that should be
it.
We're
now in orbit above Fallbrook, Captain.
Alright. We'll turn it into Haram, and then we'll double dip and get extra brownie points with the board. Nothing wrong with making both sides, you know, come to blows. Nothing wrong with it all. Also, we get a little bit extra money on our end and a little more experience. And in the end, chat, it's all for the people. You know, that truly is what matters. Yes. Yes. The ends will justify the means. Mm-hmm. Alright, am I going the right way? Yes. I can go up here and just kind of cut over. Oh, hi, Manta Queen. Ooh, Mega Manta Queen. All right, I'm just gonna go booper. So I want to see how strong our weapons got, because last time it took 9. Oh, hi. Hits to take her out. Okay, there's 2. There's 3. There's 4! Woo! Ooh, not bad, not bad, not bad! It might be a little broken. Yep. It might be just a smidge on the broken side when it comes to, melee. Like, not a lot, but just enough to where it's noticeable. Please tell me I'm going the right way. Oh, hi, guys. Oh, wait. No, sir, come back. Come back. Baby, come back. You can blame it on me. Oh, hi. Wait a minute, it's close. Oh, did I do something? Yes! Okay. I actually did something smart. Then again. Forgot about the mines. Oh, wait a minute. Are you, who the hell are you guys? Oh, you're the mercs that he hired that clearly didn't work. Well, Actually, I think he might have a store, a vendor here that we can get rid of some of this stuff. Yeah, okay. Oh, there it is. You think that he would have taken the time to clean out the bodies? At least a few of the bodies. Yoo-hoo! Where's the way to get up to you, my friend? Oh, that's the bathroom. I could have sworn it was through this door. No, he won't respond. That's the exit. Oh, it's the elevator, that's right. I forgot about that. Alright, give a second here, chat, while this is going up. Oh, it's finally starting to show winter outside, and it is getting rather cold out. Your goodies here. I mean, you're not using them, dude, right? Yeah, of course you're not. Atmospheric controls. Environmental sensor status. All sensors currently indicate a standard level range. Okay. Automechanical controls. Why give me that option? Oops. Okay, get all my loot. Okay, here we go. God damn, dude. It takes a while to get to you. Okay.
Do you hear that? It's the blessed sound of radio silence, which leads me to believe you have sweet, sweet news for me.
I have sweet, sweet news. MSI and the Autoclass are no longer transmitting. Is the data ready?
Yes, indeed. I am back in business. But before we get down to it, might I ask how you handled the problem in the end?
Doesn't matter.
I suppose not. Curiosity was always my besetting sin, and we both know I'll find out eventually. I don't doubt that you are working with Phineas, but my contract specifies I relay any acquired information to the purchaser, and to the purchaser alone. However, to send the data, I will need your assistance in cycling the antenna's receiver so I can input the needed adjustments.
Phineas doesn't trust many people. How do he hook up with you?
You make it sound so scandalous.
A little bit.
Phineas has been in hiding for the past 35 years. He got in touch with Neoka first, who I use as a physical go-between. The rest is history.
And I bet I have a whole new checklist of crap I gotta do before this works, right?
Ugh, don't be ridiculous. We're resetting a broadcast tower, not filing taxes. There are no errands, spreadsheets, or rituals involved. It's simple, truly. I merely need you to waltz outside and throw the lever to cycle the power. I'll key in the numerical adjustments from in here.
See, he says that. That's it. You're not pulling my leg.
Someone has trust issues.
A little bit.
Though I can't hardly feign surprise. Yes, that is all. No, I am not mocking you. Much. Just step outside, flip the switch, depart forever. Understood? Good. Marvelous. We're in agreement.
Don't burst a blood vessel, huh? Okay, got
terrific.
It.
Terrific. I'll be here, waiting with bated breath. Give a shout if the panel electrocutes you.
I don't have a choice. Smart ass. What the hell? Give a shout of the electrocute suit. Yeah, no, it's gonna. Alright, so why is that not popping up? The airway is clear, da-da-da-da-da. It's time for him to get to work. Weird thing is. Oh, jump start the radio. Purifies poisons, toxins, venoms. Fight what nature inflicts. Bad nature. Bad.
Testing 1, 2, check. Sweet stars. But that is a beautiful sound. Can you hear me? We are a go for broadcast.
We are a go.
I also dispatched Phineas his data. Impatient prick.
Actually, I think that's the wrong one.
I'm now indebted to him for it. Now I'll kindly thank you to get out of my tower.
Happily, I won't bother you again.
Look, I am well aware that at times I may have the tiniest iota of a prickly exterior. But I must admit, I have grown rather fond of you. Take care out there. What in the nebula? Wait, a message just broke through. It's a mayday. They've breached the atmosphere.
Oh no, it's the, that's... I was gonna say, oh, it's the board! If it was, clearly they did not survive.
Black holes, did you see that?
The big ball of fire, no, totally missed it.
Look, there's not enough room in this tower for two sarcastic hullheads, so one of us has to knock it off. Right. I reckon we both know who that'll fall to. Oh well, a pity for the crew, but I can't see how it affects me.
Hiram? Can you hear me? Did you see that?
Architect, save me from swindlers and fools. Sanjar, what are you bloody doing on my channel? Did MSI or did MSI not cease broadcasting? Yes, but... Hiram, are you there?
Oh God. It's like three blind mice. Will someone explain what's going on? Ah, it's a reunion. Group hug.
Not without a physical contact waiver.
Ah, the good captain. The truth brings us together once more. Our salvation has come crashing through the stratosphere. We need only...
Because I'm expecting that quick.
Are you mad? That's a UDL gunship. You'd probably shoot your own toes off.
You're acting like children.
Par for the course, really. You should do like I did. Get out while you still retain a shred of sanity. We could use the gunship's armaments to defend Stellar Bay, but we need its targeting module. Our message is so close to breaking free of this planet and spreading to the stars. Help us secure that module and we will save our colony. Listen, I don't care a single whit what you do, so long as you leave me out of it. Which means, get off my bored damn channel! I'm more than finished with you lot.
Ooh, that's death. Careful. So, I take it... Is that actually part of the main story? Return to Haram, right? Speak with Phineas. Speak to Percival. That's a separate thing. Okay. Speak with Phineas. Speak with Percival. All right, let's go speak with Haram. And then we'll rush over... Speak to Percival, or Phineas, then Percival, and then yeah.
So much for peace and quiet. Would it kill the universe to cut me some slack?
So, I'm here to shut down all legal interplanetary broadcasts. I'd like to secure some information. I'm gonna go with the number 2.
Allow me to assure you that I know absolutely nothing about any allegedly illegal broadcasts. Surely the board is aware of that. They must
know
I never involved
right?
myself in such despicable activities. There's utterly no reason to arrest anyone in this broadcast station, let alone me. In fact, you're doing me a favor by helping me disable any alleged such broadcasts, if they exist. You could do me another favor by mentioning my loyalty to the board in your report.
I love how they didn't... The one thing... that Obsidian did not account for was somebody playing both sides. And I was kind of hoping the dialogue had changed a little bit. You're laying it on a little thick. You do know this, right?
Am I?
A little bit.
Odd, because I cannot possibly fathom what you mean.
Mm-hmm.
Reckon this cartridge I found lying around, containing a not insignificant sum of bits, might lay it on to the right thickness?
I reckon it would. Attempting to bribe an agent of the board. Yep.
Excellent. Yes, that is reassuring to hear indeed. I am glad we could come to an understanding. And as you've already shut down the transmission from Amber Heights and Stellar Bay, you've effectively ended all unregulated chatter on the planet. I suppose it won't kill me to work under Sophia. I am on familiar terms with her from a, let's call it a past contract job.
Mm.
As I am now inextricably in the board's service, I'd say we're done here. Unless, of course, you require anything further.
No, I'm good for right now.
Give my regards to Sophia, won't you?
Okie dokie. Now, speak to Percival. Speak to Phineas. Return to Sophia. Oh, that's Byzantium. All right, let's go talk to Phineas. Where did I park? Parked somewhere. Nope. Wait a minute. Take a walk outside. Man, that didn't actually screw up my ability to leave that. Nope, it didn't. Okay. I'm gonna say that ship crashing shouldn't have interfered with me leaving the planet. Let me go ahead and rest.
Please kindly inform the crew that long chats with Ada are not required every time the captain leaves the ship.
But they're bored. They want friendship, companionship. Come on. Phineas, are you willing to talk without being behind a bulletproof window? Maybe?
We've arrived at Phineas's orbital lab.
Friendship can never truly begin until you come out of your shell. Yeah. Oh, nice. Did not notice that until now.
You. I'd clap you on the shoulder if I weren't behind a wall of bulletproof glass.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how you did it, but Hiram Blythe just sent me everything I needed. According to Hiram's message, Minister Clark has ordered a suspicious amount of dimethyl sulfoxide. It's almost as if he's hoarding the colony's remaining supply. Typical elitist. Hoarding supplies during a time of scarcity. Once I have those chemicals, we can revive the Hope's colonists and put some decent people in charge. So, good news. You're going to Byzantium and stealing those chemicals.
What? Oh no! What's so important about these chemicals?
If I had time and several blackboards, I could explain the details to you, but to put it briefly, dimethyl sulfoxide is the reason you're alive today.
Ah, so good enough.
The chemical is absolutely essential to reviving the Hope's colonists. I need you to steal as much as you possibly can. The more, the better. If you don't bring me enough chemicals, I might not be able to save the Hope's colonists, and then nothing will stop the board from destroying this colony.
Ooh, can I bring too little? Is that an option? What about Minister Clark?
Aloysius Clark, Minister of Earth. Virtually every colony requires the presence of a Minister of Earth. Clark is complicit in every one of the board's crimes. Whenever the board issues some new decree, you'll find Clark's signature on the dotted line.
Okay, you make it sound so simple.
Oh, I understand it must seem impossible to you. Infiltrate Byzantium, the crown jewel of the colony. Steal a batch of rare chemicals from a heavily guarded estate.
You're not making this better?
In order to do the impossible, you must first divide it into a series of smaller, less impossible tasks.
So what's the plan? Actually, that, as odd as it sounds, that's really good advice. break a problem down into smaller bits. You have an end goal? Go by steps.
Ah, yes, the details. I'm not about to ask you to rampage through Byzantium trading bullets with the board's agents. We'll have to resort to subterfuge.
Oh no.
Carmen Imagawa. She's my contact in Byzantium. Meet her at the docks. She'll have all the necessary intelligence you require.
52,000 experience.
I'm bringing my old nav key to Byzantium. You'll need it to land in the Golden City. Remember, you're looking for dimethyl sulfoxide. Big green bubbling vessel with a warning label. I'll take as much as you can find.
Anything I should know about Carmen?
You can trust her if that's what you're asking. Imagawa is the finest special agent in Byzantium that money can buy. My money, anyway.
Actually, there was something else I wanted to ask you about.
Of course, of course. What's on your mind?
Never mind. I felt like I had more questions there, but it's like, oh, nope. You know. I get 10 points. Dialogue? Dialogue works. Combat dialogue abilities. You've unlocked it. Oh, when attacking the correct type of target, they are automatically debilitated. Whoa, wait, what? 20. Humans have a 20% chance to cower in fear for 3 seconds after the first time you hit them. Ooh, okay, like that. We'll dig that. Reduce the detection radius of enemies when you have no companions in your party. Melee damage returned as health. Yeah, I'm gonna grab that. You can't kill me!
I'm the perfect weapon. Born. Forged. Get ready.
I'm gonna save. Let's go get some drinks here. Man, that looks like shit, but I'll take it. Actually, wait a minute. Hold up. I think that might be... Ew, that's better. Yep, that's better. Okay.
Welcome back. Do wipe the blood and space dust from your feet in the...
And let's go to the port first, and then we'll go talk to Akande.
We're now in orbit above Byzantium, Captain.
Or Akande.
I'll lock up behind you.
Slim and Shine. Diet toothpaste. To give you that good spacer's choice smile and figure to boot. Oh, wow. This is actually... Man, this, shitty as this looks, it actually feels pretty awesome. Hi.
Do you mind? I'm meeting someone.
What a... I am meeting someone too. Oh my god. Are we meeting like the same person?
Maybe.
Oh. You mean I'm supposed to be meeting you.
You know, sometimes I feel like they take my dumb responses as sarcasm. Which I guess you could if you viewed it as sarcasm. Which would be a very polite way to view it as. Why do you sound so surprised?
Nothing, it's just... I thought you'd be taller.
I'm short, I'm sorry.
Anyway, let's not get hung up on that. The Phoenix is a wanted man, and the board has eyes everywhere in Byzantium.
The Phoenix?
Yeah. That's my codename for... You know. Our mutual friend.
Oh. We have a mutual friend? Oh my god, how nice.
He did a good job finding you. You'll fit right in here. Anyway, you're looking to make contact with Minister... Magpie, right?
Magpie, right? Yes, Magpie.
I should warn you, it won't be easy. He spends most of his time in his estate, which is heavily guarded.
That's okay. I got a heavily guarded hammer. There's got to be a way to catch the minister someplace less protected.
Afraid not. He almost never leaves his home, and his guards never leave him.
Can't you get me into the minister's estate?
Whoa, I'm not one of your B&E specialists. I just provide intelligence.
I don't know. You seem pretty good with birds and whatever E stands for. Energy.
Birds are kind of my specialty. Codenames, too. But I can give you some information. Some of the guards hang around Billingsley's House of Inebriation between shifts. Maybe you could do some reconnaissance there. You know, swipe a key while nobody's looking.
That's theft, not reconnaissance.
Whatever. I'm better with bird terms.
Yeah, clearly. And how exactly did you get involved in all this, anyway?
I've always been fascinated by birds. If you ever research Earth species, there are thousands of them. So colorful and distinct. The other thing about birds, though, is their environmental indicators.
When they die off, it's a sign that something's wrong.
Exactly. I started thinking about everything we see around Halcyon, and all the things we don't see.
Like what?
For starters, you rarely come across anyone living in Byzantium who wasn't born here, even though we get ships in all the time. Doesn't that seem strange to you?
Well, are we thinking like cloning here, or have they figured a way to prolong a person's life? Does?
And then there's the way nothing gets fixed. There used to be a suggestion box around here. People would drop ideas in. Nothing ever came of them, of course.
Okay, my theory about Earth having totally been destroyed and the corporation's not too sure what to do with that, and they're just hanging on for dear life while they're riding basically a bull into hell. That might be more true than I thought. It's not right. But it actually seems pretty normal, actually.
Sure, that part is. That's why they install shredders in those boxes, after all. But one day the shredder broke. No one came to fix it. And since it wasn't working, we didn't have anywhere to file our complaints. So you can imagine how messy things got.
A regular tragedy.
At first, management put up an out-of-order sign. But that just seemed to worry people. Like they were advertising something wasn't working. They eventually took the whole suggestion box sign down so that people didn't have any expectations about it. But they never fixed it, never replaced it. Doesn't that seem odd to you?
If you ask me, the suggestion box was pretty useless to begin with. No, that's how things go around in Halcyon, in case you didn't notice.
Except that's not how they go. At least that's not how they're supposed to go in Byzantium. The whole episode made me wonder, if they can't fix something as simple as a suggestion box, what else aren't they fixing?
Everything.
After a while, I got connected with our mutual friend and started using my position here to feed him information when I could. That's it, really.
All right, let's go talk to Conde. I wonder if a Conde might have something a little more substantial then. Thing is, if Earth is dead, they weren't really getting shipments from Earth, though, as far as I'm aware. It was all self-contained.
Some crew members are causing a disturbance on the ship.
And it's also, as far as I know, there seems to be intelligent people, like engineers working hard, that sort of thing. There's actual scientists developing, building, creating. But where's the blockage?
We are now in orbit above Byzantium, Captain.
Like, there's something. I can see they're getting supplies, right? Like, necessary components. Maybe, but maybe it's just fresh ideas, or worse, not enough genetic pool, you know, like, to grab from, so babies are not being born. But that wouldn't stop them from, like, building things, fixing things. They could be hoarding everything they have, which would be dicky.
I've just finished reading a report of your work on Monarch. The broadcasts have been silenced at last. Unfortunately, Sanjar Nandi and Graham Bryant still draw breath. I would have liked to be rid of them, but they're no longer important. And you brokered an alliance with the broker himself. Hiram Blythe is a valuable asset. Well done. Your work is exemplary. You've earned a place in the chairman's inner circle. Congratulations are in order.
Wait a minute, do I get to meet him? So, you were watching me on Monarch?
No, I haven't been watching you. I've been reading reports of your work. You're better than an adventure serial. Now, we introduce you to the chairman's plan. Turn your eyes to the screen.
Good afternoon. I'm Chairman Rockwell, and I'm here to address a serious issue facing us. As you all know, our colony has been successful beyond our wildest dreams. Unfortunately, we've recently discovered that our food supply will not be able to sustain Halcyon's population in the long term. Everyone will die. Everyone will slowly stop living from malnutrition. But we're doing it together, and that's what matters.
I fucking swear, if someone doesn't give me something to read that will placate the masses soon, all of you will find yourselves violently unemployed.
But I can assure you there's nothing to fear. We've got a solution. It's called the Lifetime Employment Program. We will freeze most of the colony to preserve resources, while the best and brightest of Byzantium continue living in prosperity.
Look, you idiots! How many times do I have to tell you we can't say shit like that? Fire whoever wrote this!
While Halcyon's brightest minds solve the problem of our nutritional shortage, the rest of the colony will be placed in suspended animation. Individuals will be revived on a rotating basis so that every Halcyonite can be part of the important work of saving our colony. By testing paperweights. Sorry, couldn't resist. Let's go again. And someday, in the not-too-distant future when we've solved this crisis, we'll all be back together again working for the good of Halcyon. Until then, the board shall provide for the deserving just as it always has. So, obey your supervisors, take your vitamins, follow your corporate mandated grooming rituals, and rest assured with the board on your side, there is nothing to worry about.
Okay, there's 50,000 people on that ship.
Halcyon is on the verge of a total systems collapse. The truth is ugly and difficult to accept, but we must accept the truth before we can move forward. Malnutrition is already a problem. Disease will come next, followed by starvation, followed by a breakdown of society, followed by extinction. I know this must come as a surprise to you. I imagine you have questions.
I got a few. Okay, we need to talk about that lifetime employment program.
I'll answer however I can.
Okay, so you don't honestly believe all this lifetime employment nonsense, do you?
The Lifetime Employment Program is not some malevolent strategy of an evil mastermind. There's no dark secret buried in the fine print. The program is logical, it's reasonable, it's merciful. And most importantly, it will work.
I saw the presentation. Rockwell wants to sacrifice the colony to save Byzantium.
Byzantium is the beating heart of our colony. And as long as Byzantium survives, Halcyon may one day recover from the collapse. We must protect this city at any cost. Help me execute the Lifetime Employment Program, and you will have earned a place of honor in Byzantium. You will live in comfort and want for nothing.
You do understand that you guys seem to be, like, hitting the status quo and only maintaining that status quo. You have no desire to go past that without, like, burning out anything you can. How long do we have?
We've already crossed the point of no return. The collapse has already begun. You must have noticed the signs in Emerald Vale. Malnutrition, disease, high mortality rates. This is a permanent famine, Captain. We've done all we can to curb their hunger. Very soon, people are going to realize they're starving. A famine is a problem of logistics as well as marketing. Your workers must remain productive on as little food as possible, and they must always believe that food is plentiful.
How did you manage that?
corporate-approved rationing, company policy on dietary restrictions, appetite suppressants. Before you interfered in Roseway, Dr. Anton Crane was on the verge of developing a powerful appetite suppressant. It would have made his career. The solution is a temporary one. Before long, our workers are going to feel the effects of starvation. The Lifetime Employment Program is our only viable option.
What's your take on all this?
When I first discovered the truth, I was shocked, even disgusted. I wondered how we'd allowed a colony like Halcyon to fall into disarray. But the more I thought about it, the more I realized the colony had sown the seeds of its own destruction. We have become lazy and decadent. We smother ourselves in meaningless bureaucracies. We deliberate and argue and procrastinate.
It's not the kind of language I expect from a chairman's own adjutant.
I've served the board long enough to understand its weaknesses. Running a colony requires swift and decisive action. The board is slow, ponderous, and prone to squabbling. That's why I'm relying on you. You deliver results without the paperwork.
What does any of this have to do with me?
When you turned Phineas Wells over to me, I knew I could rely on you. You've demonstrated your ability to place duty above sentiment. And you deliver results. That quality alone is enough to separate you from the board's army of indecisive bureaucrats.
Not a fan of bureaucracy, Sophia?
Do you know how many meetings I have to sit through? How many papers I have to sign before I can make one decision? I'm only trying to rescue Halcyon from extinction. I can't save this colony alone. I need someone capable of working outside the system. Someone who can get things done.
Tell me what you wanted.
We need to talk about Emerald Vale. Thanks to your meddling, Edgewater is without power. Operations have ground to a halt. You've left us with a useless town draining our resources. Edgewater needs to go. I want you to wipe the town out.
Wait,
no survivors.
What? I don't understand. What did Edgewater do to deserve this?
When you diverted power to the botanical lab, you spelled the end of Edgewater. But the town is still hanging on, still living off whatever meager resources we send them. With every passing day, Edgewater leeches more of our limited resources. The town is a rotting limb, and we must be surgeons.
Holy shit! The board is responsible for this colony. This is all your fault.
Because we were negligent. You're right, the colony can't possibly feed itself. And it's our fault. This is our mess. And the only way we're cleaning it up is by taking action.
Taking action now?
I'm not asking you to be a murderer. I'm asking you to be a surgeon. Edgewater is a necrotic limb on the body of the colony. It must be severed.
Just like that. Edgewater not productive anymore, so wipe it off the planet. That's it. Game over, man.
We don't have any other option. A colony is on the verge of collapse, and we no longer have the luxury of easy solutions.
Okay, wow, this game... we're evil, I'll do it, but... Like, hot damn. Okay, give me a second. I'll be right back, chat. I'm just gonna go to the back.